Hello and welcome. Welcome to online worship with Caledonia Presbyterian Church. My name is Pastor Janice Doyle, and it really is a privilege and a blessing to have you join us across time and space, where we gather to pray, to praise, to learn, to encourage, to journey this thing we call life. Being adopted into the family of God isn't about doing more or trying harder. It's actually about being welcomed by God. Why? Because of God's radical grace. Because of God's radical love. It's about being set free. It's about never being alone. So welcome to this place and space of worship. We may not be related by physical blood, but the blood of Jesus unites us all. And so I invite you to come, prepare yourselves for worship. Take a nice deep breath in and out. Try to be aware of how you're feeling physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Allow yourselves to feel what you feel. As we settle in to worship, we're just going to play a little piece of music as we prepare to worship together. Psalm 92 verse 1 says, "It is a good thing to give thanks to God and sing praises to the name Most High." So here we are. God blesses us with gifts of love in relationships that bring joy and gratitude. God blesses us with talents and opportunities to serve, all we need for faithful living. God protects us in times of danger and guards us in times of trial. And so we gather, especially this weekend, we gather to offer thanksgiving to the Lord our God. Praise be to our God for all good things, now and always. And so I invite you to pray with me. Let's pray together, shall we? God of all creation, in this season of harvest and thanksgiving, we're struck by the beauty around us. Autumn sings its praises, leaves in bright colors, birds flying south, fields ripe, combines and tractors going in our own neighborhoods. Such beauty speaks of your goodness. On this, what we call Thanksgiving weekend, renew our gratitude, Lord, for all you have given us in the fruitfulness of creation. Renew our gratitude in Christ Jesus, who teaches us how to walk wisely and humbly on this earth that you made. For all your good gifts, we honor you with thanks and praise now and always. And yet, Lord, we know you are the God of our lives, even in these challenging times. We know we enjoy an abundance that so many cannot even imagine. Yet, we confess, Lord, we don't always recognize these blessings. We worry about the future. We worry about whether our families can or will flourish. Lord, forgive our fears of going without. Show us how to share the goodness that is already ours. Forgive us for the times we've gone astray. Forgive us when we're not grateful. Forgive us for the things we've done and the things we've left undone. We lay it all at the foot of the cross. In the powerful name, in the powerful blood of Jesus, that we pray. Amen. My friends, I stand before you each time we come together like this, and each time we come together in person as well, to tell you that God's not mad at you. God just desires a relationship with you. God wants you to draw near to the heart of God. God wants to lavish love upon you. Rest in the knowledge and the assurance that you are forgiven. When we bring ourselves to the cross, when we bring ourselves to God, when we ask for forgiveness, forgiveness is ours. It is a wonderful, beautiful gift of grace and love and mercy. It's all about love. If God has a religion, it's love. If Jesus has a church, it's love. If the gospel has a message, it's love. If faithfulness has a standard, it's love. If sin has a lesson, it's love. And if life has a purpose, it's love. It's all about love. Rest in that knowledge of God's love. Bask in God's love. Allow yourselves to be loved by God. Open yourself to the love of God. We are a forgiven people. Thanks be to God. And so as we come to our time of scripture, we pray that the Holy Spirit will open our minds, our ears, our hearts to the living word, that we may be transformed, that we may become more like Jesus. So first, let's turn to the letter of James. James is the brother of Jesus. It's actually one of the shorter letters in our New Testament scripture. I invite you to read the whole letter, but we're going to read James chapter 4, just a few verses, starting at verse 6, where James writes, But he gives us more grace. That is why scripture says, God opposes the proud, but shows favor to the humble. James continues on with instructions to say, submit yourselves then to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Come near to God, and he will come near to you. Wash your hands, you sinners. Purify your hearts, you double-minded. Grieve, mourn, and wail. Change your laughter to mourning and your joy to gloom. Humble yourselves before the Lord, and he will lift you up. Words of living scripture. And now we're going to turn to the Gospels once again, where Jesus continues traveling, healing, teaching, preaching, showing us the way, the truth, the life. We're going to pick up a passage here where Jesus comes across 10 lepers in Luke chapter 17, starting at verse 11. Now on his way to Jerusalem, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee. As he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, Jesus, Master, have pity on us. When he saw them, he said, go, show yourselves to the priests. And as they went, they were cleansed. One of them, when he saw he was healed, came back, praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus' feet and he thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. And Jesus asked, were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner? Then he said to him, rise and go. Your faith has made you well. This is the living word. Thanks be to God. Going back to the letter of James once again, we can read in the first chapter that every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. Here we are on what we call Thanksgiving weekends. Canadians across the country celebrating a long weekend, many with families and friends coming together at bountiful tables. And yet, for many, these tables will have empty seats as families, including some of our own here, who pain at now empty chairs once filled with a loved one's presence. If you're happy and content and grateful in this time right here, right now, especially on this weekend, then perhaps our time together, this devotion, may not be for you. But if you're like so many of us, or if you've ever experienced a time when it's hard to be grateful, especially when the whirlwind of life knocks the wind right out of us, well, let me assure you, you're not alone. Sometimes it's hard for us to feel grateful, especially in a season, in a time when we've lost loved ones, or we have loved ones battling horrific diseases. The big C cancer is horrible. We have people we love fighting for their lives. Or we know people in the community who don't have that huge meal, the bountiful table full of food and desserts, because they just can't afford it. Or maybe there are so many that have to work over this so-called holiday weekends, and they have to work just to make ends meet. It can be hard to find that emotion of gratitude when you're tired, of circumstances, when you're fatigued by your emotions, or even perhaps when you feel a tinge of jealousy when your friends or someone you know just seems to have everything going for them. I get it. Life is hard enough, and sometimes holidays and get-togethers like these make it even harder. But you know, that is precisely when we, as followers of Jesus, we need to double down. We need to turn our eyes toward the Lord. We even need to ask for help. But not only ask the Lord for help. Sometimes we need to shut ourselves up and listen. Now, I don't know about you, but sometimes when I sit down and pray, I sit there and I bring it all before God, and there are times that I plead as well. I lay it all out there, and then after the amen, I get up and I get back to work and I set about the tasks of the day or my to-do list. There's so much to do, hit the next item, whatever might be ahead of me that I need to tackle. I finish the amen and I carry on. But sometimes I need to remind myself too, to shut up and listen, to really quiet myself, to allow myself to be still. There is a place of quiet rest where we can draw near to the heart of God. And when I draw near to that heart of God, when I am silent, I can't help but be thankful as a response. And when I draw near to that heart of God, I can experience that gratitude. And don't kid yourself, gratitude is important. Even with so many barriers that try to keep us from being grateful, it's a hard place to be in, because we can't just make ourselves feel grateful. We can't just snap gratitude out of the air and feel that gratitude all of a sudden. It's a hard place to be in. There will always, always be times in life when feeling grateful is like the last emotion that we can try and drum up, whether it's stemming from our circumstances, life itself, trauma, grief, fear. These all impact and overshadow our ability to recognize the good things that are around us, the good things that we have going for us. And then especially on weekends like this, there comes that whole societal pressure all around us to be grateful. It's Thanksgiving. We're supposed to give thanks. But our gratitude should come from a place of authenticity rather than a place of obligation. As I said, we can't just make ourselves feel that gratitude. But the good news is you don't necessarily have to feel grateful to be grateful or to show gratitude. You can live a life of gratitude even if you don't feel it at times. You see, gratitude is a practice. It's an action that we can choose to engage in, that we can choose to live in right here, right now, alongside all this other messy stuff going around us. We can choose to act in gratitude. The act of choosing gratitude can actually have amazing benefits to our lives, especially helping us to cope when life is hard and times are tough. And growing our own sense of gratitude is actually, it doesn't happen overnight. It's an ongoing process in life. And we don't necessarily fix our feelings or even our circumstances, but it can certainly add to our support network. And all you have to do is just start right where you are. Start right where you are. Acknowledge how you're feeling, no matter how challenging it may seem. One of the things that helps me when I'm finding myself falling into that messiness, that ick, sometimes I call it a funk. One of the things that helps me is a gratitude journal. Now, whether you keep a journal or you just sit down and make a list. Make a list on a loose piece of paper. Start right there. And I truly recommend this. And if this is something you'd like to start, you can start today. And try not to be too general with that list. I know we put family and we put friends and we put food, but I invite you to get really specific. Get into some of the minute, tiny little details, even the little things that you're grateful for. Did somebody do or say something nice to you? Did you see maybe a comic strip in the newspaper or as you're scrolling through social media? Did you see something, a silly meme, that brought a smile to your face, that made your heart feel at least a little bit lighter? Things like that. Write it down. Be specific. And then say thank you. You see, because when we express gratitude, it's like shining a spotlight on someone or something, shining a spotlight on a positive aspect of our lives. Saying thank you actually acknowledges the kindness of someone, something that made you smile. So if you're making lists, why not reach out and say thank you to that person? It might feel silly or awkward at first, but I guarantee you, it will give you some positive emotions that overflow out of that experience. You see, because gratitude helps us reframe the world around us. The world around us, the world that can seem so dark and fearful and tough sometimes. We know the world is hurting. Just turn on the news. But as we reframe ourselves and we get into that practice of expressing gratitude, the practice of gratitude itself, there are actually some amazing and scientific benefits of practicing gratitude in our lives. Studies have shown how this gratitude can have a very positive impact on all of our lives. Gratitude improves mental health. It can help lower those levels of depression and anxiety. It can help promote a positive and more stable mental state. This is essential for our own well-being and even quality of life. And out of that, we get better physical health as well. Research shows that practicing and expressing gratitude is associated with improved physical health, reduced stress, lower blood pressure, even a stronger immune system, which in and of itself, these all lead to healthier lives. Expressing gratitude, practicing our gratitude, gives us a greater empathy for others as well, more compassion for others. Gratitude encourages us to recognize the situations of others and even respond with more kindness, care, and compassion. And out of that, all from the art of practicing gratitude, we build stronger relationships. Expressing gratitude fosters deeper connections, stronger bonds with friends, families, colleagues. It creates a positive flow, an appreciative atmosphere in our personal relationships. How can you not recognize some of these benefits? Practicing gratitude keeps the cycle going, and in turn, that gives us increased resilience in tough times. We have better emotional health. The cycle helps us to cope a little better, not if, but when those times get dark and tough again. Grateful people tend to recover more easily from the setbacks of life. A life of gratitude makes it just a little bit easier to pick ourselves back up when we fall down or when we get knocked down in the storms of life. This leads to more stress reduction, and life is stressful enough. And out of all of this, this practice of gratitude can come increased happiness, joy. Because you see, gratitude is the antidote to feelings of dissatisfaction and unhappiness. The practice of gratitude helps us focus on the positive aspects of life. What's going on well around us? Things may be falling apart over here, but what about over here? Are things going well? Let's be grateful for that. It gives us a little glimmer of light, a glimmer of hope, perhaps even a glimmer of happiness and satisfaction. And out of all this comes increased motivation. Because you see, a life of gratitude can foster that positive mindset, even when it's difficult, to jumpstart us and to get us motivated to do something instead of lamenting about it and finding ourselves in that dark and miry pit. Even a little something can give us a sense of purpose. So perhaps after all of this, you might be thinking, well, I'm just not there. Or maybe you're thinking, yeah, I'm just not feeling it. Or you're thinking, I don't even know how to get started. Lean in on God. Find that place of quiet rest. Draw yourself near. Be still and know. Lean in on God, and then lean in on us. Lean in on each other. Your faith family. We are here for each other through the good times and through the not so good times. When we connect with others, when we share experiences, when we support each other, it's a reminder that you, that I, that we are not alone in this world. Coming together helps us to appreciate one another, the diversity, the differences in people and perspectives, and how we all contribute to this rich and beautiful tapestry of life. Being a part of a community, especially a Christian faith family, helps us to see the goodness in people, the acts of kindness that are all around us, the way we all come together to make life better. It's like a front row seat to the awesome potential of what's around us, a front row seat to what God is doing in the world, in the here and the now. Start where you are. I know it may be hard sometimes, but allow yourself the chance. It may not always be easy, but believe me, it's worth it. Happy Thanksgiving. Hallelujah and amen.
Oh,
Let's bring our hearts and minds together and let's pray. Kind and generous God, as we give thanks for the harvest, we pause to praise you for all things, both great and small, those things which fill our lives with meaning and offer us a sense of well-being. By your Spirit, O Lord, may we have a grateful heart. Merciful and generous God, as we give thanks for all the harvests of the earth, show us how to live respectfully in creation and protect all that is precious to you. In a year and when harvests vary across the country and across the world, show us how to share what's been produced so that no one goes hungry. By your Spirit, O God, help us have grateful hearts. Just and generous God, we pray for the well-being of your world and our very own community. Where there's hostility between nations or neighbors or families, inspire leaders to show wisdom and courage in decision-making. We pray for areas hard hit by flood, storm, fire, earthquake, hurricane. All those who are struggling, all those who have to rebuild. May neighbors with resources maintain generosity and compassion for the long work of reconstructing lives and livelihoods. May we all give thanks with a grateful heart. You are a healing and generous God, and we pray for those facing health challenges. We pray for those facing difficult times for any reason. We pray for family and friends under stress, in sorrow, journeying with grief. Give us patience and understanding as we draw near to them. Lord, we ask that you draw near to them, near to the heart of God. May they draw near to the heart of God. And help us, Lord, to reach out with compassion. O God, in Jesus Christ, you have given such generous love and mercy. Through our lives and by our prayers, Lord, we ask that you reveal this love and mercy so that we may be beacons of light and hope to others. It is in the powerful name of Jesus that we pray that perfect prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And so as I thank you for joining us once again, may you find time to draw near to the heart of God. May you cherish each day as God's gift so that you can gain a wise heart to live in gratitude, with gratitude for all of God's goodness. So may the God who made you, the Christ who mends you, and the Spirit who brings you life bless you and keep you this day and forevermore. Amen. As you go forth into the world in peace, go in hope, but above all things, my friends, go in love. Amen.